Good morning, coffee drinkers. Today is all about how I prepare for a gig, what I take with me, and how I turn this Frankenstein pedal mess into something I can pack into the car, take to the gig, and that will hopefully work for the duration of tonight's show with Bobby Reynolds at the Blue Whale. Okay, time to put the Frankenstein pedal board in the Pelican case. Okay, a little multitasking here. Gotta get some La Croix in the fridge. And at the same time, talk to you guys about what I'm thinking about before I'm going to a gig. Now, today it's not my own gig, it's someone else's gig. And I'm very fortunate that I'm really familiar with the music. So my time isn't spent, at least today, it is not spent learning new music or revisiting music that I haven't played in a while, because we play, you know, once a month, sometimes twice a month. And I've been playing with Bobby for 20 years, so it's not too much of a stretch in terms of the material. We are playing with a different piano player tonight, Vardan of Sepien, who we all went to Berkeley with, super great friend of ours, incredible piano player. It's gonna be a lot of fun, a little bit of a change of scenery in terms of the harmony, I'm guessing, from Ruslan. They're both beautiful players, both very different. So I'm thinking about that for sure. I'm thinking about the possibilities. And I'm thinking about what kind of musical landscape we might get into and how I can best set myself up for success with that. But then I gotta tell you, it's like a lot of kind of silly things, like maybe non-musical things. Like normally we play at the Baked Potato, for instance, so it's right down the street. I can get there in 6 or 7 minutes. So if I forget anything when I go out to the sound check, I can always come back home and grab it before the gig. Not really the case with the Blue Whale, because it's downtown. I could come back, I guess, but definitely not as easy as the Spuds. So as silly as it may sound, I'm definitely thinking about like really not forgetting anything. I guess you should do that every time, but I get lazy playing at the Spuds. So I'm kind of conscious of that today. I'm also conscious of the fact that it's a different room. It's a room I don't play that often, although I have played there before. It's kind of that like that concrete box kind of vibe, which can be great if you know how to deal with it and how not to like smash the Saabs and like, you know, do the wrong things for the room. So I'm definitely thinking about that. And whereas on the sound check, like I said before, I'm not really gonna have to be dealing with brand new music. I'm already thinking about how I'm gonna deal with the sound check sonically and get the best possible sound as quickly as possible so we don't drag out the process. And then silly things like bring in a clean shirt or something like that. Like, I've had this on most of the day. I've already packed the car, gone grocery shopping, practiced, done a bunch of things. So I'll wear this to go into the sound check, but then I'll have a shirt for the gig. Maybe I'll have a second shirt for the second set, and then maybe a third shirt to come home with. I don't know, just simple stuff like that that I quite often overlook just because I don't play that often in town. Maybe I am preaching to the choir here and you are all way more experienced than me, but if you ever question like, how do you get ready for a gig? What are the best things to take? Like, besides the gear, there are a few real practical things that you can be thinking about when it comes to being 100% prepared for the gig. And more than anything, and very much more these days, like more so than 10 years ago or 20 years ago, I'm working on the relaxation element. I'm working on having everything, like having no anxiety as I get to the gig. Now, I'm not talking about nerves. I'm just talking about the rushing thing. I don't want to be late. I mean, I never want to be late for anything. That's just a given. But I don't want to be running on a schedule where I'm like under pressure and I'm running around, I'm sweating bullets, you know, carrying my gear and setting up. I don't want to be the last person there. I'd much prefer to be the first person there and be really relaxed while I set up and take my time. Far better to be early on the sound check than it is to be late. And not only is it good for me, but it's good for everyone else as well. It's good for the music, it's professional, it helps you stay hired and stay employed. It might be the most important thing we do, is like being on time, being courteous, being professional, you know, being totally cool and relaxed so you create that environment around you. You want to make the people around you better. The only thing that's really on my mind is how do I enhance the experience of everyone around me? The audience when they listen to us, the other musicians when we play together, whoever it is, the person working the door, the person behind the bar, the fan you run into, like how do you make other people's experience better? And through that, you're gonna have an amazing time. At least I do. When I think like that and when that's my outlook, when that's my concept, I have a much better far more relaxed and way more fun time no matter where I am and what I'm playing. I think we're all set with liquid in the fridge. Ever since I got the new car, I've actually been really good about keeping the trunk empty and not full of crap. So when I do have a gig, which as you guys know is very rare, but when I do have a gig, I can actually just roll out with my gear, throw it in there, and not have to worry about emptying it. I'm already sweating more than I would like, but running on time. And luckily, my load-in is nothing like Chelsea's Burlington Coat Factory story from the other day. Even though the parking lot is a little bit far from the club, there's an elevator, should be able to do it pretty much in one go. So that big long line of traffic and that thick red line on the navigation, as far as the eye can see, is one of the main reasons I do not like playing shows in LA. Now the cops are coming from behind, probably not a good idea to be filming. We've got to talk to Chelsea about this, about the different driving experience that it is being a freelance musician and working around Los Angeles and Southern California all the time, because this traffic is brutal. So with all of this crap, just about the only thing, ironically, I can't carry at the same time is the camera. But I think I can do the whole thing in one go. Get out of here, I'm first. How you doing? Janek.
Ryan.
Ryan, nice to meet you, man.
All right.
I beat Bobby to the gig. He's coming in right now.
Pardon me, fellas.
Hey, hey, good sir. Good chap. Hello, Bob.
I'll see you
tomorrow.
Your name is Bob, man.
How about that?
Yes!
The man is here.
Oh, come here.
It's Fardan.
Uh-oh.
Fardanovic.
With an ice cream.
With an ice cream, holy shit.
Dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate. Thank you.
Thank you.
So that's it. That's the cycle of getting out of the house, going to a gig, sound checking, working on some tunes with someone who hasn't played the music that much before in Vardan, who Bob and I were both at Berkeley with some 20 years ago, and playing a really successful gig. It was a lot of fun. It's about 12:30 at night right now, and I have about an hour or an hour and a half of editing in front of me for the vlog, for today's vlog. Chelsea is right behind me, which is awesome. So she will be asleep before this vlog gets uploaded, but she came to the show. It'd be nice to have a couple of steady gigs where I got to play music with great musicians and really good friends. That would be pretty awesome. Maybe that can be a new goal, is having my own local thing in town, playing my own music with awesome musicians on a regular basis. That would be a lot of fun. And on that sentiment, on that rather positive note, I will leave you guys. Today's vlog is done. I will see you tomorrow.